Tim was not and is not a painter. So I didn't know he had this whole little sub-obsession with Vermeer.
Tim's Vermeer project started 11 years back in 2002 when his daughter gave him a copy of David Hockney's book, Secret Knowledge. Hockney wrote that when pictures started to look less like this and more like this, that was because artists had found new tools to help them. In 17th century Holland, high-quality lenses and mirrors were in use everywhere. Telescopes were all the rage, and science hobbyists were experimenting with ways to project live images. Hockney challenged conventional wisdom by suggesting that when artists of Vermeer's day began to paint more accurately, they were no longer using just their eyes and their imaginations. They were secretly getting help from optical machines like the camera obscura. Tim went around the world studying Vermeer.
They called it painting with light. Vermeer painted with light. You can't paint with light, you have to paint with paint. And so what they're really talking about is this verisimilitude that Vermeer has that it just pops. You see it from across the room and it looks like a slide. It looks like a color slide, a Kodachrome. Seeing the Vermeers in person was a revelation. It reinforced to me that I was on the right track, that what I was seeing was an accurate representation of the color in that room. I just had a hunch that there must be a way to actually get the colors accurate with mechanical means, some way you could do that in 17th century. To test this, I propped up a high school photograph of my father-in-law on the table. I put a piece of masonite down here to paint on. I sent a small mirror at a 45-degree angle. And for the first time in my life, I did just what Vermeer may have done. I picked up some oil paints and a brush. In Vermeer's camera, this would be a projection. A lens is projecting this image, but to show the actual mirror painting process, we're using a photograph here. You can see that there's a reflection, and then there's my canvas down here. And right at the edge of the mirror, I can see both things at once. I'm just going to apply paint and either darken or lighten the paint until it's the same exact color. And at that point, when it's exactly the same color, the edge of the mirror will disappear. All right, and I'm an idiot at this. I have done this process exactly twice in my life before. What I'm doing is I'm moving my head up and down so that I can see first the original and then my canvas. I'm looking at both things at the same time. Right on the forehead, you can see that they match because you can't really see the edge of the mirror. That's your clue that you've matched the paint exactly. It's not subjective, it's objective. I'm a human, a piece of human photographic film at that point.
What you're doing here is you're essentially blending?
Yep. I am either darkening or lightening the paint that's already on the surface.
You aren't tracing any lines because there are no lines.
Yeah, that's a characteristic of the Vermeers that makes them unusual is that there weren't lines, and there weren't any lines drawn underneath the paint either.
Before Tim went to all that trouble, we thought he should run his idea by a working artist. So we called up our friend, Los Angeles-based painter and entertainer, Martin Mull, and asked him to meet Tim in a studio in Las Vegas and see his gizmo.
Oh my God. Holy cow.
It took me about half an hour to learn how to operate a paintbrush.
Uh-huh. Oh, good for you. It took me 40 years.
Well, and the beauty of this technique is that you can make mistakes and see what you did wrong instantly and try to fix it.
This is astounding.
The Queen of England owns Vermeer's music lesson, and she has it there at Buckingham Palace. We thought, since we were in England, we'd stop by the palace and check it out. But the Queen said no. So we shot a whole tirade against the Queen. But then...
Well, I just came out of that building. That's where the painting is, Buckingham Palace.
The day before Tim returned home, the Queen changed her royal mind. She granted Tim a private audience with the music lesson. He had 30 minutes to study the painting. The deal was he could only record the experience in his head. No photography allowed.
And it was a great 30 minutes. The painting is amazing. It's very different than I thought it would be. The reproductions don't do it any justice at all. The colors are more muted. It's slightly darker. It's got a kind of an overall bluish cast. But the astounding thing is the amount of detail. I put on my magnifying binoculars and looked at the virginals, and every stroke of that decoration is there.